morning and thank you for joining Cookbook Publishers for our webinar. My name is Rachel Turner and I will be your host. Today's presentation is You Type It Online Beyond the Basics. We'll be covering the following key points: benefits of using You Type It, reviewing and changing your order settings, reviewing page options, project planning, and how to complete the order. Before we begin, I have a few quick notes. All callers will be placed into lecture mode to avoid interruptions during the presentation. To ask a question, please click the question tab. At the end of the presentation, Stephanie will address the questions submitted and also those submitted during registration. This presentation is being recorded and will be available on our website. With all that being said, let's go ahead and get started. Please welcome Stephanie Jones. Stephanie concentrates in business development and customer service at Cookbook Publishers and has since 1995. She's been in the cookbook business for over 35 years and has a ton of knowledge within fundraising, printing, and everything in between regarding cookbooks. Thank you for joining us today, Stephanie. We're ready to begin when you are.
Well, thank you, Rachel, and thanks for everyone who took time out of their schedule today to join us for this webinar on the really more detail of using the You Type It Online recipe software. You know, as you know, the software is one of the ways that you can submit your recipes to cookbook publishers. You can send them to us to type for you, but there really are some great benefits to using the You Type It Online software. And the first is that you can actually earn a discount just by typing and proofing your own recipes. That discount is 25 cents per book, up to $300 off on your order. So let's say you're ordering 400 cookbooks, which is actually a pretty average size order. It's a nice size order. With the 25 cents off per book, that's $100 in your pocket right away. And that's before any other coupons, seasonal coupons or discounts would be applied. The next benefit is also really great, especially if you've got committee members or you've got family members in different parts of the country, and that is the software is available 24/7, any time of day or night from anywhere that you are, as long as you have got computer access. Because it's browser-based, if you have got internet access, then you can log on, like I said, any time, day or night. There is no limit to the number of people who can be in the account at any one time. So if you have got committee members in Supply, North Carolina, and you have got committee members in Charleston, or you've got family members in Kansas and family members in Michigan, whoever is associated with that account can be in there entering recipes or performing their tasks that they're assigned to without regards to whoever else might be in there. And then the third is that you can actually get your cookbooks faster just by typing and proofing your own recipes. For instance, if you send them to us to type for you, then it takes about 30 to 40 business days from the time we receive all of your materials until your books are ready to ship. But by using You Type It Online, we can shorten that production time because the recipes are already ready when we get your order. So you can reduce the production time for us by about 10 to 15 days, which means you can have your cookbooks ready to ship in about 20 to 25 business days. This is a really important feature, especially at this time of year when we're approaching the holiday season, because as you probably know, Christmas time is the most popular time of year for cookbook fundraisers and also for personal cookbooks for family members. So this is a really great feature for you, knowing that just by doing your own typing and proofing, you'll have a little bit extra time to complete your cookbook and still have them in time for Christmas sales. A couple of things that I want to remind you are that Cookbook Publishers has used Firefox in order to develop our version of You Type It Online. So you find it at cookbookpublishers.com. When you get there and you click on the link, I would go ahead and bookmark that page. But do be sure that you use Firefox as your browser. The benefits and the features in You Type It will be optimized and you'll have a better experience at this time if you use Firefox. The other is that we have a downloadable user guide that's available for you. You can see a PDF of it right underneath that little orange Start Now button. You can download it, you can save it to your desktop, you can share it with your committee members or the other users who are going to be entering recipes. They can also download their own version. It's like a little mini tutorial. So it has a lot of information in there. And if you have a question, and maybe you are taking advantage of that 24/7 and you're typing recipes and or setting up your account, and you have a question and we're not available at that time of day, you might be able to find the answer in that user guide. The other thing to remind you of is that we always have tutorials available for you online. We see if you're new to setting up your account, then you would probably benefit with the Using You Type It Online, because that one covers the basics of the software. If you would like to refer back to this webinar, then it'll be available on our website. And then, of course, as Rachel mentioned, you'll have a link to it in a follow-up email after the presentation today. So with all that being said, let's go ahead and log in with your username and password. Remind others as you give them a username and password and they log in that this is the page that they're going to see when they first log in. And what they're going to want to do is click that edit button so that they can access your cookbook account. The reason it is done like this is because you may have other cookbooks that you're working on at the same time, maybe one for your church, one for your school, or maybe you're doing a family cookbook and doing one for an organization that you belong to. You want to make sure that you're working in the right cookbook account or the right you type it account. So always select the one based on the title and of course the order number, and click that green edit button over to the far right. When you do that, it's going to bring up this Manage Cookbook page here. And depending on the your user level will depend on which of these features are available for you to access. So for instance, I'm logged in as the chairperson, so I can access all of the different features of this Manage Cookbook. If I'm logging in as a recipe contributor, then really all I'm going to have access to is the recipes and the message center. I'm not going to be able to change any of the order settings. I'm not going to be able to request approve. I'm not going to be able to submit the order. But that's okay. That's what the chairperson and your co-chair are for. So depending on the user level that the chairperson assigns you when she adds you to the account will depend on those things that you can access. And let's just go ahead and look at a video here real quick. And I'll talk you through the different features that you have got. Your order settings, the recipes, the member options, of course, that's where you add and edit your members. The message center is great if you want to email directly out of you type it. Proofing the cookbook with the magnifying glass and submitting the order. Notice that all of the icons match the menu at the left, so you can use either one of them. And also see here that those same icons in that menu carries over from page to page. Your general information in the user settings gives you your order title and the name of your cookbook if you've decided on that. The status of the order, which right now is data entry because it's not been submitted. We know that a soft cover has been selected, and right now we're thinking maybe 400 cookbooks. Users information tab, this is where you will go to access all of the users that are currently in the account by either adding or editing their information, and you can see what their user level is. Page options is for the additional pages outside of the recipes that will be included or can be included in your cookbook. And the other thing to note here is whether or not you want to have subcategories. If you do, we're going to come back to this a little bit later and we're going to say, yes, we want subcategories. So I can show you how to do that today. Recipe sections, this is where your categories are already predetermined by the chairperson, but right now she can add categories. She can remove categories with the little minus button over to the left. She can rename the categories just by typing a different name in that bar, and she can move them with the little blue drag and drop feature. Your design options will let you determine the order of the recipes on your recipe page, and then also other features you want to add to your recipes, like recipe notes, whether or not you want page fillers, the recipe format that you like the best. And remember, you can review all of them just by clicking on that last format or next format button. When you find the one that you like, you click the little radio button and save the order. Now, before I move on, I want to remind you that all of these settings, all of these options can be changed by the chairperson right up until the time you submit this order for printing. So while you saw an option to proof the cookbook, know that that is a free proof that you get as often as you like, as many proofs as you like, and it will show you exactly how your recipes are going to look on the page. What you'll be able to do with that proof is obviously review, compare to the recipes that you have, make sure that you don't need to make any changes to it. But if you do see something in your proof, you are welcome, and we encourage you to go back to your recipes in your account, edit that recipe, make the changes, and save it. Just by sending it for proof does not make any changes. So what you see in that proof is exactly the way your cookbook will be printed. So it's important for you to remember that. All right, let's talk a little bit about the user's information. And remember, I said this is where you can add and edit your members. And I've got another video that I'm going to show you. So first, we're going to start out by clicking on that blue user's information tab. And we'll just walk through the process here. Let's get our video going. Sorry, sometimes I have to kind of hover there. So right now, we can see we have got six members in this account. I can add or I can edit. So let's go ahead and edit a user first. I'm going to change, let's change Donna Reynolds from a co-chair to a contributor, just to show you how to do that. So I click the edit button next to Donna's name. And right here at the very first thing is the level that I assigned to her. I change it from co-contributor or co-chair to contributor and save the changes. Okay, so let's go back to our settings. And now this time, and you don't have to do it this way, but I want to see as if you were doing it from the first time. Go to your members and add a person. Just like when you were setting up your account, the chairperson has got required fields that you're going to have to fill in to add a member. That, of course, is going to be their first and last name, the level, their status is automatically going to come up as active, which is what you want it to be, and then their email address is the required field. If you like, you can go ahead and put in the other contact information, so you've got everything right here in your uTypeIt account. You don't have to leave the program and go to another software program on your computer or go back to your email. Everything can be done right here. Assign her a username and a password, save it. And now, when we go back to the user's information, we see that we have got Brenda Williams as a contributor. We've got Rhonda Elliott as a contributor. Donna Reynolds is a contributor because we just changed her. We've got Stephanie and Levi as co-chairpersons, and we've got Debbie as a chairperson. And remember that Debbie Irvin is the person who is responsible for editing the user's information and saving it, making changes there. So when we finished here, then we can go ahead and go to some page options.
Thank you so much, Stephanie. The video demonstration was really helpful, by the way. We do have a question from Marilyn Wentworth, and she's asking if more than one person can access the uTypeIt program at the same time.
Hi, Merlene. Yes, that is a good question. And yes, it is one of the features of the uTypeIt Online that multiple people can access the account at one time. And not only that, but you could actually be, if you have two accounts set up, let's say, one for a family cookbook and maybe one for your organization. Even though the same login information is used for both, you can have somebody in both accounts at the same time. It doesn't make any difference. You have unlimited access and unlimited users in your account at one time.
All right, great. Thank you, Stephanie.
Sure. Okay, let's go ahead and look now at the next blue tabs in our order settings, and that would be the page options and the recipe sections. And I group these together because they go together so closely, and this is where we're going to take care of those subcategories and organizing recipes. All right, let's get our little video going here. We'll look at the page options first. The free nutritional information pages, you'll actually see those in the PDF proof if you request to have those in your cookbook. And if you want a really good example of those, check the sample cookbooks that came in your kit. Remember I said we have to say yes, we want to add subcategories before we can really go in and do that in our account. So we're going to change that to yes. I like to have a contributor index because I think it's nice to be able to see all of the page numbers of everyone who submitted a recipe. So I'm going to say yes to my contributor index, and also that I wanted that cookbook order form. I save my changes, and now I go to the recipe sections, and this is where I can add my subcategory names. Notice that I can still use the little move button to drag and drop the categories into a different order. I can add more subcategories. I can add more recipe categories. Not only can I move the categories themselves, I can rearrange the order that I put the subcategories in. So you have got a lot of flexibility here as the chairperson to be able to make changes and get your cookbook set up exactly the way that you want it. And you know what? If you decide later on that you want to have your categories in a different order, or you want to have your subcategories in a different order, or maybe now you've decided that you want to include a breakfast section instead of maybe putting a subcategory in main dishes for breakfast, you can still do that. The thing is, once you have your subcategories set, when you add a recipe, now not only do you select the recipe category, but right there on that same page, you've got a separate drop-down menu that shows all of the subcategories that are available for the main dishes category, for instance. So you know that when you put in, let's say a tater tot casserole, that you want to be under the beef subcategory because it's got ground beef in it, then you will have that subcategory name open up and you'll be able to select beef. Now, if you have got recipes that you don't want under a subcategory section, maybe you've decided that you want your tater tot casserole not to fall under beef. You just want it to be by itself. So what you're going to do is not select a subcategory. And that means all of the recipes that you do not assign to a subcategory will appear first in your main dishes section like that. So if you have any questions about that when you are requesting your proof, and how to assign the recipes to a subcategory, or you need help moving them, then please give customer service a call or get in touch with us on chat or send us an email, and we will be more than happy to walk you through that because we want the recipes in your cookbook to be exactly the way you want them set up. All right, let's look now at our design options and our recipes. And actually, what we're going to do now is within the recipe sections, I told you that you can categorize them and choose the order that you want them. So if you go to your recipe list and you see all of the recipes that are entered so far, you see their status, you see one that's still on data entry, and you know you want it included in your cookbook, go ahead and edit that recipe. Change the status to approved and then save it. When you do, remember your preview box comes up and you say accept changes, and that locks it in as an approved recipe. But let's say now you want to group those recipes together because you want to see how many recipes you've got in each category. Right now, all we can see is how many recipes we have all together in the cookbook. So we're going to go back to our order settings, and we're going to go to the design options, and we want to make the order status or the order of the recipes custom order. And by doing this and saving it that way, now we can go back to our recipe list, and you see we have a new orange tab available that says organized recipes. Click on that orange tab, and now you can see the recipes that are in every recipe category and recipe subcategory. You see the order that they're appearing in. You have the ability to change the order just by using the blue move button over to the left. You have the ability also to change the order by renumbering them in the white box, but you can go through every single category that you have, see how many you have, how many are in the subcategory, and you can move them. If you like the order that they're in, just save it that way and it will lock them into that order. Now, if you decide that you really don't want them in a specific order here, maybe you want to have them in alphabetical order on the recipe pages. That's fine too. You can still do this custom order to be able to see how many are in the categories. And then when you've done that, before you submit it, go back to that same design options, change the order to alphabetical right before you submit, and that will lock them in alphabetical order. So the Organize Recipes tab just gives you a couple of different features. You can either use it to put the recipes in a custom order, or you can use it to see how many recipes you have within a particular recipe category or subcategory. I will mention that you notice while we're here in this organized recipes and we're on the vegetables, you see we've got one that's still on data entry. I can't edit the recipe from here. I have to go back to my recipe list and click edit next to that roasted potatoes recipe in order to go in and change it to approved status. So I just wanted to mention that while we're here. Okay, we do have some deadlines that we want to make sure that you're aware of. We always like to bring these up when we're getting close to a deadline, especially at this time of year, and just to help you with your project planning a little bit. We do have a different deadline for recipes that we're going to type for you and recipes for when you're using YouTypeIt Online. And for Thanksgiving, if you would like to have your cookbooks in time for Thanksgiving sales and we're typing the recipes, you want to make sure we have absolutely everything in your order by September 19th. It has to be in our office, not postmarked. We have to actually have it physically in our office so that we can check it in. That means recipes, any custom artwork, your cookbook order form, a prepayment if you're an individual or family, so that we can start working on it right away. However, if you're doing the typing and proofing yourself with YouTypeIt Online, you have until October 10th to get that order into us with the same qualifications. We need the recipes, the order form, any non-recipe material, and prepayment, whatever we need in order to start on that. Your deadline is October 10th, because remember, you've already taken care of the recipe portion of your cookbook. Now, if you're looking at Christmas sales, you've got a little bit longer. It'll be an October 15th deadline for us to type the recipes for you, or November 7th. So you can go all the way out to the end of the first week of November if you're using YouTypeIt Online. Now, I say this with a caveat, and that is the earlier we receive your order, no matter if it's for a Thanksgiving deadline or a Christmas deadline, it doesn't make any difference if we're typing the recipes or you're typing the recipes. The earlier we receive your order before those deadlines, the earlier you'll receive your cookbooks. So for instance, let's say you want cookbooks for Christmas. You're using the YouTypeIt Online. In order to have your cookbooks by the 25th of December, yes, you have until November 7th, but those cookbooks might not ship until December the 14th. So that's going to put the books to you just barely a week before Christmas. So keep that in mind when you're planning your project. If you want your cookbooks by a certain day in December or a certain day in November, call customer service and they will help you set up a timeline and work backwards from the day you want your cookbooks in hand to when you actually need to submit the order for us. Okay, final steps for completing your cookbook. Of course, as we have mentioned in the past, YouTypeIt is only for the recipe entry. And you noticed that as we were going through here again today, we didn't talk about a cover. We didn't talk about a divider set. We didn't talk about the personal pages or any ad pages that you might want to include. YouTypeIt is only for your recipes. So how do you get that other information to us? You do it with the cookbook order form. and it is sent to us separately of your uTypeIt account. When you're ready to submit your recipes, remember you click that little green arrow and you get a notification that Cookbook Publishers has received your recipes. Your account is locked. You can no longer access it. But you still need to send us your order form. We need to know who to contact if we have questions. We need to have the address for who to send the invoice to, and of course, where you want to receive your cookbooks delivered to, how many books you're ordering, and the number of recipes in your account. This is a good way for you to start determining the cost of your order so you can set your selling price. Because the first thing that you look at in how much the books are going to cost you is the number of books that you're ordering and the number of recipes. And then, of course, you take your discounts out, you add your optional features to that to get your final cost, and that helps you determine your selling price. You'll select all of your design elements here. You'll choose the cover, your binder, the dividers that you want, the recipe format, and the design options for your recipes. Of course, those are selected in uTypeIt, but you want to make sure when you're filling out your order form that they match. Sometimes people don't realize that we're going to compare one to the other when we get the recipes and when we get the order form. So it just makes it a little quicker getting everything checked in. If before you submit the recipes, you fill out the order form and make sure that they match. And then, of course, your personal pages and any non-recipe material come to us separately from the recipes. You want to read and sign the contract on the back, which is on page 4 of the order form. And then you can upload, fax, or mail any non-recipe material to us. You can email the order form. But we do ask that any artwork is sent to us via the upload feature at cookbookpublishers.com because customer service isn't able to accept artwork directly into their email. It goes to our design department who will review it, and then customer service will get back with you if we have any questions or if you have requested feedback on the artwork that you are submitting. Okay, let's go ahead and just kind of do a summary of the things that we talked about today. We showed you how to change or edit the settings in your account and reminded you that you can do that as many times as a chairperson as you wish, right up until the time you submit the cookbook. And you know, I actually encourage you as you have set up the account and recipes are being added, go ahead and request that proof when you've got a few recipes that are approved, because you can start to see how your cookbook is going to look. If maybe you don't really care for the format that you chose in the beginning, change it to a different one and request another proof and see how that one looks and find the one that you like the best, because you want an attractive cookbook that everyone in your organization is going to enjoy and all the members in your group are going to appreciate and know that you really took time to make special selections there. We showed you how to create subcategories, how to put the recipes in a custom order, how you could move everything around. We went over the design options like the fillers, recipe notes, things that you can add to your cookbook, the subcategories, an order form in the back of the cookbook so that people know how to purchase copies of the cookbook. We don't keep them here. They have to get them from you. So you might want to include that order form in the back of the cookbook. It's free. It gets the word out there and people know how to get additional copies. And then we went over how to submit the order form and how to actually submit your recipes and everything for printing. Before we get into questions, I want to mention that we do have a special promotion for you. So anyone who has signed up for the webinar today, on the back of the order form under the special instructions, if you will write the promo code WEBINAR0818, then we will give you an additional $25 off of your order. This promotion is good up until orders that are received November 7th. Which is your Christmas deadline for the uTypeIt. So if you're just about finished up with your recipes and you're getting ready to submit that order, go ahead and include that promo code on your order form and you'll be eligible for the $25 off on your order. Okay. All right. I think I'm ready here, Rachel. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to talk over you there, but I think I'm ready here if anyone has questions.
Okay. Well, thank you so much, Stephanie. We've covered a lot of information today regarding UTypeIt Online and had several questions come through. So let's go ahead and get started on answering those for our audience. So the first question is from Kitty Peeler, and she asks, when I print the recipes within a category or subcategory, the list prints by entry number. Is it possible to print this list in alphabetical order?
Hi, Kitty. Thank you for joining us today, and thank you for your question. That really is a good question. What you can do is when you say that you want to print the list of recipes, when it comes up, it's going to be in the recipe number by default. If you click on the wording title at the top in your preview box, it will change them to alphabetical order, but it won't print them that way. So if you want them printed that way, what I would do is just use maybe a clipping tool like there's a snipping tool that is part of Microsoft, and you can use that snipping tool and you can just do a snip of that page when they're in alphabetical order and then paste it into a blank document and print it out that way rather than printing it directly from that screen that opens up. Unfortunately, there isn't a way to print the list in alphabetical order. You can only view it that way. So I apologize that it doesn't do that and that I have to give you a workaround. But the other thing that you could do, you know, if your recipes are on approved status, and we would hope that they are as you're going along and having recipes added, is just go ahead and request that proof and go to the index. Because if you have said that you want the recipe index to be in alphabetical order, you can look at it right there and you can see every recipe in every category, just like it's going to be in your book. So that's another option for you that might be a little bit quicker and easier than using the snipping tool.
All right. The next question is from Christina Craddock, and she's asking, or she says, we're almost done typing 600 recipes. What's next?
Wow, Christina, that is amazing. Congratulations on the participation that you've had to get so many recipes. That is going to be one fabulous cookbook. So what you want to do is obviously you want to request a proof, and you can, if you wait for that proof, wait for that link, you can share that link. You can email that PDF to whoever is helping you, your chairperson, or even other people if you want them to review their own recipes again and help with the proofing process. You can share that PDF with others, but go ahead and check your recipes carefully. Make sure that you get all of your edits, all of your corrections done, and that everything is ready to submit. You're perfectly happy with the way the recipes look in the PDF. And then go ahead and fill out your cookbook order form. Make sure that you get any custom artwork uploaded to us if you're doing a photograph on your personal pages, or if you want to send a Word document of the your title page, your expression of appreciation page. Maybe you're including a history page or a committee page, whatever you want on those four pages. Make sure that you get those ready to send to us. And again, you can upload those. And then once all of that material is ready, go ahead and get the signatures you need on your order form and upload that or email it to customer service. Do that when you submit your recipes. And what we will do is we will compare your UTypeIt to the order form. We'll make sure that nothing got missed. If it did, we'll give you a call and we'll get some other information from you. Now, I will say that if you are a family or an individual, if you're not an organization who is going to be invoiced for your cookbooks, but you're one of those that is prepaying for your order, put a note in the special instructions on your order form for customer service to call you for credit card information. That way, you don't have to include that personal information on the order form. We don't want you to put it in an email. We don't want you to type it on your order form. We want to give you a call so that we keep your information secure. So just do that. And as soon as everything comes in, we'll figure out what your prepayment is and we'll give you a call so you can make that initial payment. If you prefer, you can mail your order form with a check and not do the credit card. It's entirely up to you. But either way you go, if you are looking to meet a deadline, make sure that we have it in our office by those critical dates that I gave you. And good job, Christine. That is really awesome. I can't wait to see your cookbook.
Yes, it is. 600 recipes. Wow.
I know. Okay. You spent some time with that.
It'll be well worth it.
I'm sorry. I hope she's doing a three-ring binder because Rachel, that is just awesome for a three-ring binder. Yeah. Really. Okay. All right. Let's move on.
Sure. Okay. So the next question is from Skip O'Neill, and he's wondering if it's possible to add color photos, such as photos of a finished dish, to a recipe page.
Hi, Skip. That is a good question, and thank you for joining us today, and thank you for your question. Yes, photos can be added to your recipe pages, but it's something that you can't do and you type it. The way that we take care of that for you, though, is you go ahead and you prepare all of your recipes. You get the photos that you want to go with them as a high-resolution image, as a JPEG preferably, and you save it with the name of the recipe. And then if it's with all of the recipes that you want to do, it's a different way to handle it, I would put them on a flash drive. And send them to us that way. If you just want to include a photo of a few recipes, then go ahead and upload it. And the reason I say if it's like with all of the recipes or with a lot of the recipes using a flash drive, it might just be quicker and easier for you because you are limited on the file size that you can upload at one time to Cookbook Publishers. So it just might be easier if you use a flash drive. But what you do in the process is, like I said, you name the photo by the recipe title. And then when we receive the photos and we receive the recipes in your account, Cookbook Publishers will go in and force the space for those photos, and we will add the photo to the page for you. It's going to be a special quote. You won't go by pricing on the price chart or the cookbook order form. So I do encourage you to get with customer service to get more information on submitting those photos and for special pricing for your cookbook. So I love to see cookbooks like that. We have done several where customers have wanted to have photos of their recipes included. It makes such a nice presentation. Thank you, Skip.
It really does make for a nice presentation. The next question is from Camille Wayne, and she's asking how the best way to handle long recipes.
Well, hi, Camille. Thank you today for your question. That's a good question. I hope I'm going to answer this the way that you asked the question. If you're talking about recipes that maybe have an extra long method, is that what I'm going to assume that's what you're talking about? Maybe something that has got a lot of steps, like sometimes a bread recipe is really long because you've got, you know, the yeast bread, you do the proofing and the everything. So what you can do, instead of putting the entire method in one recipe method box, add another recipe part and say that that is a method, and then you can separate that long method into different paragraphs. I still wouldn't add, you know, more than a couple, because you don't want it to carry over to a lot of pages, simply because when people pick up your cookbook and they see a really long recipe like that, it's a little bit, to me anyway, I guess I shouldn't speak for other people, but to me it's a little bit intimidating to see a recipe that's that long, and I think, oh my gosh, how am I going to have time to do that? And it might be the most wonderful recipe, but I'm going to let you bring that to the holiday dinner, because I don't want to spend that much time in my kitchen. I love them, but anyway, that's just a personal preference. But that is an option for you, is to add more recipe parts so that you can divide that recipe up into even different ingredient lists. Like you've got a cake with an icing, and each one of them has a separate list of ingredients, and you want a separate method, by all means, you've got one ingredient list and method for your cake, add another recipe part, make that your ingredients, add another recipe part, and make that the instructions for the icing and save it that way. And you'll really like the way it looks on the page that way. So I hope that I answered your question, Camille. If not, get in touch with customer service and they'll help you with that.
All right. Next question is from Rosemarie Taylor, and she says that her recipes are different sizes, and she's asking what the best way to make two recipes to a page look more uniform.
Hi, Rosemarie. Thank you for your question. You know, some of that is going to depend on the recipe format that you choose. And I would encourage you to try different formats and see which one you like the best for that. But you have got different ways, remember, that you can organize your recipes on the page also. So if you say that they are in custom order, and then you request a proof, and you see which recipes are falling together on the pages, now go to your organized recipes and rearrange them a little bit, and you'll be able to balance them out a little bit more to your liking. But do look at different recipe formats also, because, for instance, the Premier format, a lot of recipes in that one will only be one to two per page just because of the way the format is set up. So you might try that designer option format and see if you like that too.
Okay, and the last question we have today is from Joyce Leon, and she's asking, when you click the Proof This Cookbook button, does the proof design the pages and also check the spelling and grammar?
Hi, Joyce. Thank you for your question. That is a good question because we have had people ask that one before, so you're not the only one who is curious about that. The answer is no. The system does not do any editing or flag any inconsistencies or typographical errors that might be in the proof. All it does is run it through the formatting software so that you see exactly what it's going to look like on the recipe page. So what I would do is just keep that PDF open over to the side on your screen, go back to your account, and when you see something that needs to be changed, go right to that recipe immediately, edit it, save it, and the next time you request a proof, it's going to be correct in your proof. But no, it does not do any editing or proofing when it goes through the software. That only formats it for the page. Good question.
That was a good question. It looks like that's all the time we have for today, so we can start wrapping things up. If we didn't have time to get to your questions today, one of our customer service specialists will be in touch with you right away for personal assistance. We will be sending you a follow-up email, which will include a link to the recorded webinar and presentation slides, just in case you need to revisit any of the information or share with fellow contributors. Stephanie, thank you so much for taking the time to meet with all of us today to show us how we can customize our cookbook. And thank you, everyone, for joining us today. We hope you learned a lot and enjoy the rest of your day.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Rachel, for your help today. And thank you for everyone who joined us.